Welcome to the third and final video in the elevated raised bed series. If you missed part one on the concept of growing from an elevated raised bed, or part two, the construction of an elevated raised bed, these can be found on the OSU IPM YouTube website. This video assumes you have an elevated raised bed to start working with.
Now we're going to go ahead and build the frame to fit around the top of the raised bed box that's going to hold the support structure for the row cover.
Take your 8-foot long 2x2-inch lumber and measure it into 56-inch and 39-inch sections. Then take those sections over to the saw and cut them. Those pieces will represent the long and short sides of the frame. It might make it easier to assemble the frame if you lay all the pieces out end to end in the position that they are going to be fastened together.
So one final tip about the framing. We have here a piece of wood that's going to be the long edge of the frame, a piece of wood that's going to be the short edge of the frame, the PEX tubing, and the screw. So it's important that the long piece and the short piece be in this orientation and that the screw go in this orientation, so that when we drill this spot out to put the PEX tubing in, it doesn't interfere with the screw. If you do it the other way and screw it this way, we want to put this PEX tubing as close to here as we can, and we can't because the screw is in the way. You have to end up putting it out here.
When we're finished fastening all four corners of the frame, we're going to just move it over and set it right on top of the elevated raised bed.
Okay, so you can see the frame is on right here. We're going to go ahead and put the hinges on it. And now to see if it works. Looks pretty good. Okay, I'm getting ready to drill the holes to put the hoops in. They're going to be about an inch deep on this 1¼-inch wood. I'm going to put a hole at the edge and in the center on both sides. Okay, I've just cut this PEX tubing to about 7 foot long per piece, which is just about the right diameter to fit this 42-inch wide bed. I've gone ahead and drilled these holes into the frame themselves, so let's just stick in the PEX tubing and see what it looks like. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and put a drywall screw at the bottom of each one of these PEX pieces so they don't fall out. So these are our preliminary hoops. Now we're going to take a piece across the top to steady these up, and then we're going to go ahead and add the row cover material. All the hoops are in, and I put the cross support piece in as well to give some rigidity to the entire structure. You'll notice that I duct taped the ends so that there's less of a chance of the sharp edges rubbing against the row cover and cutting through it. Now we're going to focus on prepping the row cover to attach it to the hoop structure. So what you see laid out before you is roughly a 10-foot by 9-foot piece of Agribond 19, which is the row cover we're going to use for our project. And what I'm going to do now is just try to put a couple of edges on here that'll make it easier to attach to the structure. I've got this furring strip centered in the middle here. I'm going to put a few wraps on it with the row cover, put some staples in it, do the same thing to the other side, and then use that to drape over the hoops, and then we'll worry about the other two sides. At this point, I pretty much have those pieces of furring strip centered on this side of the enclosure structure and on that side of the enclosure structure. And now I'm gonna tack that side down. I'm gonna stretch this a little bit tight and I'm gonna tack it down here. And then we're gonna worry about attaching these side pieces to make this nice and taut. Three of the four sides of the row cover are attached to the enclosure. I'm gonna try to get this last piece. Go ahead and staple it. Just to keep it from falling all over the place. And we're going to attach it right to the top of that wooden frame. We're going to try to center it as best we can, which is right about there. Now for the final test. Yes, rotates up and out of the way. That's perfect. So this is the completed project. We've gone ahead and moved it out of the garage and into the landscape, and you can see we have the elevated raised bed. We've got the protective row cover top. We've got the potting mix in here. We've got some lettuce plants up and growing. Everything looks great. I've added a couple of wooden pieces to the side here to keep the top from falling over. So if you want to do any work in here, you don't have to worry about holding the cover with one top and then trying to do whatever operation you need to. I want to say a few quick words though about the row cover material itself. So what we used was called Agribond 19. It's kind of a mid-weight row cover. It's a spun bonded polyester type material. And while it does great to keep the insects out when it's down and protecting the crop, once the cover comes open like this, then it's kind of free game. It also has been shown to have a little bit of protection against some diseases. And when it's down, it will definitely keep weed seeds from falling in here or landing in here and germinating. Back to the season extension part of the Agribond material. Again, this is the mid-weight, the 19, and it'll give you about 3 to 4 degrees Fahrenheit protection of freeze in the spring and the fall. So if the temperature drops to 29, 28 and you have some tender vegetables or fruits or plants in here, they shouldn't get damaged. If it drops much below that, depends on how long, you might stand a chance of seeing some injury. They also make lighter weight materials and they make heavier weight materials. The lighter weight materials are really more for insect exclusion alone. They don't have but maybe 1 to 2 degrees Fahrenheit frost and freeze protection. The heavier materials, they can have as much as 6 to 8 degrees Fahrenheit frost and freeze protection. This spun bottom material does allow precipitation, rain to come through, which is great, but the heavier the grade material that you use, the more light that gets restricted from reaching the plants itself. So just remember, the higher the grade of the Agribond, the less light actually transmits through the fabric. We finally arrived at the end of our elevated raised bed journey. Along the way, I hope you've learned about the ergonomic, season extension, and pest management benefits of these elevated raised beds. If you're able to build one and place one in your landscape, I'm sure you'll enjoy growing fruits and vegetables and flowers in it for years to come.